Hello everyone, this is Satish here. So welcome to this video. This video is all about indicators of wealth. All right. So everybody will be excited about money, right? Who doesn't want money? Everybody wants wealth. Everybody wants riches. Everybody wants prosperity. So this is one of the very important video I would like to telecast here. So some indicators of wealth in Vedic astrology. So in Vedic astrology, basically second house and 11th house talks about your wealth. Second house especially talks about your assets and how much of money you can able to save, what point of time the money will be coming to you, and whether you have the saving capacity or not can be seen from the second house. And the 11th house talks about your incoming flow of gains, incoming flow of cash, incoming flow of riches and prosperity, incoming flow of gains, hopes and wishes. All these things talks out by 11th house. And 12th house talks about expenditure. 12th house talks about losses and expenses and downfall in your life. So basically, whenever we are analyzing the wealth of a person, we have to actually see especially second house, 11th house, and also the 12th house. Okay. And also, if at all the money will be coming out of fortune, can be seen from the 5th house and 9th house. So 5th house, 9th house also to be analyzed. And also, if at all wealth will be coming from the service or from the business, has to be analyzed from the 6th house and 10th house as well. Okay. And the 4th house talks about real estate, vehicles and all that. Whether you can able to make very good money through vehicles, properties and real estate, and also to tourism industry, can be seen from the 4th house. Okay, so depending upon where the wealth will be coming, that point of house has to be checked. So basically, if at all you have second house lord sitting in the 9th house, or 9th house lord sitting in the second house, or 11th house lord sitting in the 9th house, or 11th house lord sitting in the second house, or second house lord sitting in the 11th house, and also the vice versa with 5th and 9th houses as well. So if you have strong houses like second house, 5th house, 9th house and 11th house, then there won't be any kind of problem with regards to money. Out of these four combinations, at least two combinations should be there. That means out of this second house, 9th house, 11th house and 5th house, two houses has to be stronger in your birth chart. Okay. And whether the wealth will be taken off by your enemies, whether the wealth will be getting into a litigation, or else all the money which has come from your ancestors will go off from your life, can be seen from the 12th house and the 6th house. Whichever house is stronger, based on that we have to give the prediction with regards to the wealth. And wealth is very sensitive topic, right? So most of the people are looking for wealth in this world, right? So you have to find out an astrologer who can able to dig deep in your birth chart and can tell you whether you can able to get wealth from so-and-so commodities or not. Very rarely you'll find such astrologers. In my wealth astrology consultation, I'll be helping the individuals in terms of what kind of career suitable for them, what kind of events will be triggering in their life which will be giving them the wealth, what kind of commodities that they can explore to get wealth. All those things will be discussed in the astrological consultation. So that is the reason I always say to the people, please book for the consultations so that I can able to check and provide you complete analysis pertaining to your birth chart, because each birth chart is unique, each combination is unique. There are around 200 to 300 principles in Vedic astrology as per Sage Parashara and Sage Bhrigu, and as per the Horasara, and also about the sacred texts like Saravali, they have spoke a lot about Vedic astrology, especially related to the wealth. Okay, let me talk to you certain principles of it. If at all you have Chandra Mangala Yoga forming in second house, 5th house, 9th house, 10th house and 11th house, then definitely you'll become a millionaire, because most of the millionaires and billionaires around the world, like Bill Gates, and also even the in Tamil Nadu, if you take Jayalalitha, all those people have the Chandra Mangala Yoga in their horoscope. That is the reason they have got enough of wealth in their tenure. And most of the people who are millionaires and billionaires around the world all have very good wealth yoga combinations. As I mentioned to you, some kind of dhana yoga forming through second house, 11th house, 5th house and 9th house. So that's what Chandra Mangala Yoga is one of the famous dhana yoga. And also, if at all you have Chakravarti Yoga, which is formed by Jupiter and Venus, if at all you have Saturn plus Jupiter combination or Saturn plus Venus combination, that is considered as Emperor Yoga, that is one of the prominent dhana yoga, you'll be making a lot of money during the Saturn period or the Venus period or Jupiter period. Because Jupiter is the Karaka for money and Venus is the Karaka for wealth. Okay, what is the difference? Jupiter, if at all you have strongest Jupiter, you will be getting money without hard work. Out of good fortune, you'll be making money. Whereas with Venus, you have to do a little bit of hard work. You have to do a little bit of effort in terms of making money. And for the people who have Chandra Mangala Yoga in second house, fifth house, ninth house, and 11th house, if at all the Chandra Mangala Yoga is free from malefics, that is Saturn, Rahu, or Ketu, then you'll be making very good money during the moon period or during the Mars period. Okay, if at all you have, let me talk about certain principles of Sage Parashara and Horasara, as well as Saravali, okay, and Brihat Samhita as well. In these sacred texts, they have spoken about wealth in Vedic astrology. So if at all you have Saturn in fifth house and moon in the 11th house, or Saturn in the 11th house, moon in the fifth house, and vice versa, you'll be getting a lot of money during the Saturn period or moon period. If at all you have Rahu Ketu situating in the 5th house and 11th house, then you'll be making very good money during the Rahu period or Ketu period. Some people argue that Ketu will not be providing money. But let me tell you, Ketu in the 5th house and Ketu in the 11th house draws a lot of money which no other planet can able to give. Okay, and one more thing I would like to tell you is, if at all you have Mars in the 5th house and Jupiter in the 11th house, or Jupiter in the 5th house and Mars in the 11th house, that is also considered as one of the Dhana Yoga, and you'll be making very good money during the Mars period or Jupiter period. Okay, and some of the combinations, like if at all you have 1st house, 2nd house, 4th house, 5th house, 7th house, 9th house, 10th house and 11th house with Jupiter or Venus, and if Jupiter or Venus are free from malefics like Saturn, Rahu and Ketu, you'll be making a lot of money during the planetary period. Okay, and also your Navamsha chart, that is D9 chart, also has to be analyzed. And also D10 chart also has to be analyzed to find the social status, to find the authority, to find the power, to find the prestige in your life can be seen from the 10th house. What kind of profession you'll be taking it up? What kind of businesses that are suitable for you? From which commodities will be making money? All those things can be seen from the 10th house. That's why D10 chart also has to be analyzed. Okay, these are certain Dhana Yogas, and also there are certain Raja Yogas which are formed through Saturn plus Jupiter, as I mentioned to you. And also one of the Raja Yoga, Venus plus Jupiter, that is also one of the Raja Yoga. If at all you have Rahu plus Moon conjunction in 12th house, that also brings a lot of money during the foreign lands, because Rahu plus Moon combination takes you to foreign lands. If and you will be excelling very well in the foreign lands, if at all Rahu plus Moon combination, you have it in the 12th house. Okay, so this is my analysis about wealth astrology. This is just 1% of whatever I know. If at all you want me to tell you what exactly your birth chart is saying, you have to book for the consultation. You have to book for the astrology consultation. The link is mentioned in the description section. Do send me an order for the astrology consultation so that I can able to check from where you can able to enhance your financials, from what point of time you'll be making money, what point of time there is a threat for your money, and what point of time you'll be not be making the money. All those things can be determined and defined by seeing your own birth chart. So the people who comes for the consultation, I take enough of time in terms of providing them the analysis, because I'll go very deep in analyzing the birth chart. I don't think any other astrologers can go that much of deeper prescription predictions. That's what my clients have told me. I have got very good testimonials from the clients across the globe. So please don't think a lot. Do book for the consultation. The links are mentioned in the description section. Once I get an order, I can able to help you with the prediction analysis, and you can follow accordingly. And also astrology, we have to take as a guidance and the recommendations. If at all you go with the very good expert astrologers who have very good knowledge in astrology, you can take advantage of that by getting the knowledge from them. All right. So thank you so much for watching this video. And if at all you haven't subscribed to my YouTube channel yet, please do subscribe. And also next to subscribe button, you'll see the bell icon. Please click on that. If at all, if I add any new videos, you'll be notified. And thank you so much. And also do mention in the comment section what exactly you have learned from this video, so that I know that you are following my videos. And also do check other videos on wealth. I have made a lot of videos on wealth. Okay, do check those videos, and also provide your comments across the comment section, and do hit on that like symbol, and also subscribe to my YouTube channel. Do share these videos with your family and friends as well, whomsoever you love. This is the greater gift that you'll be giving to your people. Okay. Thank you so much, guys, for watching this video. And bye for now. And we'll meet up in other videos.